Hello everyone and welcome back to another album review. And in this video I'm going to review The Echoing Cell by Dennis Pond and John Weiss. This right here is a pretty short collaborative project between the harshness artist John Weiss and Dennis Pond, who is mostly known being the drummer on the indie rock and noise pop duo No Age. This is certainly an unexpected and unusual collaboration, but when it comes to John Weiss, stuff like this are not really all that surprising. For me, being much more familiar with John Weiss's works, I really like his style when it comes to harsh noise music, because it's definitely one of those cases where you can actually get some sonically impressive stuff when it comes to harsh noise. In some of his solo works, he doesn't really rely all that much on making the sounds just being harsh, having this DIY feel, and cut the sound like lo-fi material. There is actually a lot of effort put into the works he does when it comes to the noise sections, as they would sound so crisp and the textures would be excellent. I really do believe that you can find some sonically exceptional stuff out of John Weiss, and I believe that this is one of the greatest examples when it comes to solo full-length albums of his. This album over here is just two lengthy tracks that go for 14 and a half minutes long each, and it's just a pretty short album that it can end in 29 minutes. It is pretty straightforward and straight to the point, and I believe that there is a pretty nice and weird chemistry towards those two artists coming together. Dennis Pond goes into a pretty cool free improvised approach when it comes to the drumming, as you basically just get multiple drum sounds but mostly snares and cymbals, which are also mixed amazingly. I believe that there is a really good job when it comes to the mixing and the overall sound of the snares. The recordings are excellent. They sound really crisp and detailed, and they're quite powerful. It is the same thing when it comes to the noise sections as well, which at times they can become really brutal, but I like that there is a lot of variety when it comes to the approaches with the noise sections, which would mostly end up being heavily edited and giving the impression that you're listening to a cut up noise album. There are lots of different cuts, and I do really like it when there's this constant unpredictability on when each section is gonna come and go. This goes for both the noise sections and the drumming, as they would just end up being sporadic and all over the place. They don't just rely on keeping the same frequencies and the same patterns playing over and over again, and I like that there is this chaos with this release, as every single second there is something new popping up, and it manages to keep you at the edge of your seat for its entirety. Now, despite this album feeling more like a chaotic, free improvised project, there is certainly much more to it, as there are some obviously edited parts when it comes not only to the noise sections but also to the drumming. I really like some of the additional effects that are put in certain drum sections, as you can get some cymbals that could be heavily reverbed or heavily distorted and just create all of those sonically refreshing moments that showcase you that there is much more of an effort put into this album rather than just being an all over the place free improvised mess. Some of the moments over here feel really well put together, and you can also sense some patterns in a few occasions. For example, I really like that in the very first side, Fruit from Color Vapor, there is this one particular segment that doesn't really last more than like 1 or 2 seconds, that it's just this weird melodic portion that if you actually kinda pay attention to this track, you will realize that it plays more than once. It's actually an occurring theme into this particular song, following a pattern and actually showing that there is a bit of a more of a purpose to it rather than just being a mess of a song. So I really like that there are those touch of details and sounds that you see being brought back into the mix. It's actually not that hard to notice it. It doesn't really require you to pay close attention to it in order to figure it out. But I like that there are certain portions like this, or with some sub-bass low frequencies that kinda sound similar in certain moments throughout the song. And like I said, I like the huge range of noise frequencies over here, from some really heavy and amazing sounding low frequencies to some really high ones, many different glitchy parts, others that just sound extremely intense and aggressive. And like I said, all of those sections sound excellent. When it comes to the noise portions and the overall production, the textures over here are top notch. Black Fruit, the second side, basically continues with those themes, but it's not really all that different in comparison to the very first song. It becomes a bit more aggressive at times, and it has certain noise portions that it feels that it drags them out a little bit more. Me personally, I prefer the constantly unpredictable side of the very first song, but don't get me wrong, Black Fruit is another extremely unpredictable song that goes into many different phases and having many different textures and basically introducing some new sounds and synth elements as well. I believe that there are some heavy and distorted acoustic bass parts over here, and the drumming once again is pretty messy and chaotic, and it goes into many different parts with certain elements being edited and adding effects to them. I would prefer it if this track had a few patterns to it and some sounds that would repeat themselves in certain occasions, like it happened with the very first track. For reasons like this, I don't believe that Black Fruit is as strong as Fruit from Color Vapor, but I still find this as a whole thing to be a pretty compelling experience that I don't really feel I need to add more in this review. It's more of an album that you have to experience for yourselves. I personally was extremely pleased with the results out of this one. I find this to be one of the most spectacular John Wiz albums when it comes to textures, sound and production, and I can say with confidence that this is going to be one of the greatest experimental and avant-garde albums that we're gonna stumble upon this entire year. I believe that this is a pretty exceptional collaboration, and if you want a free improvised mess but also with excellent noise textures, you definitely need to check this one out. I'm gonna give the Echoing Cell an 8 out of 10. What's your opinion on this album? Like it, dislike it, why? And what do you want me to review next time? Let me know down in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe for more content like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.